It's in his hands.
You're going to sit on it?
5 seconds remaining. Butler looks like he's going for the win. Butler heaves and hits with 4/10 of a second remaining. Jimmy Butler delivers for his new squad.
Let's take a moment to break down a game-winning shot by Jimmy Butler, but really understand the details within this set of footwork, and more specifically, the space that he had to cover, the angle of the floor that he was at, in order to make this type of shot. Now, what I want to do when we work on moves like this is not just put a focus on copying moves. I'm not really big on just simply watching an NBA player perform a move and playing copycat of it, to a degree. When I want to copy a move, what I want to be able to do is understand the nuances and the ingredients that made that move special. Because if I don't copy those, I'm really missing the essence of how that play happened. See, even if I don't do this exact play in my own game, the ingredients, if I build those ingredients into my game, I can perform similar actions, and maybe I perform this exact move when it happens and when it just comes naturally in the game of basketball. And that's why I want to focus on the ingredients and what's special about the ingredients, because those can be used with other movements and so on in your game. But let's go ahead and break this down. See, if I was walking the ball up the floor and Jimmy was doing different actions and setting his defender up in the meantime, but what I want to do is really get into the very last aspect of this to really understand what happened. So as he's walking into his defender, what he does is he does a turn pound, he digs, and he gets right into a punch drag, meaning he stops on his outside leg. Now he's pretty much right in this exact same space of the floor. He's past the NBA three-point line, he's pushing his defender in, but the big aspect of it is what he does next. See, what he does is he does his punch drag, but as the ball floats, he gets his foot underneath his body. We would call that a single leg foot replacement. He's replacing his weight back underneath one leg, and now he has the ability to perform a slide step. Now this is where a mat like this is helpful. I want to cover similar space to what Jimmy covered. Now obviously I'm a little bit smaller, but the game doesn't care how big or small we are. We have to fit ourselves into the same space. And so if I can cover similar space as Jimmy, now I'm going to be able to possibly have similar opportunities. So if I have my single leg foot replacement underneath me, now I got to be able to perform my slide step all the way to the same gold area of the mat that he did. Now if I don't do that, and if I only do my slide step this far, obviously, I'm not going to cover that exact space, and chances are strong, I'm not getting that shot off. Especially at my smaller size, I better cover similar space if I want to have the opportunity. So if I can perform the single leg foot replacement and then perform my slide step to get into that shot, and obviously in this case, because of my angle, probably will require a balance kick similar to Jimmy, now I have the ability to pull off this type of play. Now, when you do these types of things, and obviously this is a very difficult shot as a right-hander on the right side of the floor, and obviously from NBA range, but when you do these types of things, try to mix up the areas of the floor that you do them, but use them to challenge yourself and really practice these types of shots in this type of space. That's the importance of doing this, is now you're replicating the ingredients that you can put into your game. One last thing I want you to be able to focus as you do some things like this is keep in mind, in the NBA, they're able to pick the ball up a little bit earlier without having any suspicions from referees because they're able to take those last two steps. When you do this, one small change I want you to make is I want you to focus on floating the ball until you're into the slide step, because the later you pick it up, the more legal it is for you. Regardless of it, if you're gonna pull off a game like this, know what happens within the moments of the play. Understand how to get from that punch drag to your single leg foot replacement to your slide step, and then that shot might just come to life for you as well.
It's in his hands. You're gonna sit on it? 5 seconds remaining. Butler looks like he's going for the win. Butler heaves and hits with 4/10 of a second remaining. Jimmy Butler delivers for his new squad.